Giving your home proper insulation is the best way to lower your heating bill and to make your living space more comfortable. There are several parts of your house that may require insulation: the attic, the walls, and the basement. Let's start with the attic. To add insulation to your attic, the contractor will need a clear path from your home entrance into the attic. You'll need to remove boxes or other items that might be stored in the attic. If the attic hatch is located in a closet, you'll need to empty that closet completely. Yep, that one too. Be aware that contractors will bring in ladders and they'll lay down tarps to protect your floors. The workers will reduce dust as much as possible, but your home will be a construction site for several hours or even a few days. So please keep any children away from the equipment and work area during this time. Once they are inside the attic, the contractors will seal gaps around chimneys and other cracks or openings. Next, they'll insulate the attic by blowing in cellulose insulation, which is usually made from recycled newsprint. This will require bringing a large hose into your house from the truck outside up into your attic. Once the insulation is blown in, the team will even insulate and weather strip the attic hatch door. The walls of your house may also need insulation. Filling walls with insulation is another way to make your home more energy efficient and more comfortable. Sometimes it's best for our expert contractors to blow in insulation from outside your home. To do this, they may remove some siding and drill holes on the outside of your house. Then they will use a hose to blow insulation into your walls. Depending on your house, this may require ladders or scaffolding. You'll need to remove everything leaning against the outside walls. Everything should be at least 3 feet from the house, so the crew has room to work. When the insulation is blown in, your walls may shake a bit. So be sure to remove any items inside that might fall off walls or shelves. After the walls are blown full of insulation, the contractor will put the siding back in place or patch the stucco. Sometimes it makes more sense to get insulation blown into walls from inside your house. When we do this, everything on the interior walls, including drapes, pictures, and shelves, must be removed. And furniture should be moved at least 3 feet away from the walls that will be insulated. I recommend covering furniture with sheeting, which makes cleanup easier, as the insulation process will be dusty. If any family members have breathing problems or allergies, they should leave your home while the contractor is working. To do the job, the contractor will drill holes about 16 inches apart and use a hose to blow the insulation into the walls. After the walls are filled with insulation, our crew will patch the holes. You'll need to lightly sand and paint the patches. This sounds like a lot of commotion, but don't worry. When the contractors are done, your home will be much more comfortable. Next, let's head to the basement. An uninsulated basement means losing heat and money. Insulating the basement walls and the top of the foundation can really make a difference when it comes to saving money and keeping your whole living space comfortable. In the basement, the contractor will need access to all of the areas that will be insulated. So shelving, boxes, and other items must be moved at least 3 feet away from the walls and equipment. And just so you know, if we add insulation to your house, and if it was built before 1978, the contractor will follow the Environmental Protection Agency's Lead Safe Work Practices. This includes adding caution tape, warning signs, and plastic on the ground to note unsafe areas to protect you and your family. As the work is completed, there may be several inspections. We'll schedule these in advance and you'll need to be home. This final quality assurance inspection will be similar to what was done during the home performance review, so we can compare the results. Sometimes your city may need to inspect some of the work, and occasionally other inspections may be needed. But these are important because we want to make sure that everything was done right, so your home is safe and snug. In the next video, I'll show you how other things in your home can affect your family's health and safety, and what to do about them. So click on the next link to learn more.